"We need never be ashamed of our tears," wrote Charles Dickens. But many in Japan disagree. Crying doesn't have a good image in Japan, says Takashi Saga. People believe you shouldn't cry in front of people, that it's weak. Saga is a tears sommelier. Yep, that's his actual title. No different, he says, from the connoisseur who chooses your wine. Selecting wines that matches food is similar to my job, he says. I introduce books, movies, and video that touch people's emotions. And that's what this audience is here for. Twice a month, Saga holds a Ruikatsu, a crying for joy seminar. He says when people get emotional and cry, life's burdens, tensions, and frustrations melt away. Laughing can only release the stress at that moment, Saga says, but study shows that the stress released from crying lasts for a week. Crying is better for your physical and mental health.
Some scientific studies back him up. When we cry for emotional reasons, as opposed to the crying we do when cutting an onion, for example, the tears we shed contain the same hormones that are released when the body is under physical stress.
Before the seminar starts, we notice lots of polite bowing and tight-lipped, poker-faced grimaces. And then, a traditional storyteller begins to spin a sad tale. And within minutes... When Saga then shows a video of emotional scenes set to Whitney Houston's I Will Always Love You, there isn't a dry eye in the house. The story about the parent and the child touches my emotion, says Aya Nemoto, and I can't stop crying. I became highly emotional, says Kengo Suda, and couldn't stop crying. I hardly cry at home, but I cried here. Once it's over, the frowns have disappeared. When it starts, Saga says, some look provocative with a try-and-make-me-cry attitude. But when people cry here, they always show us big smiles at the end of the session.
Do you feel now, having come here, that you're going to have a good week, a good month?
Yes, I think so, Nemoto says. I released my stress here. And that seems to release the smiles, even in Japan. Vladimir Dutier, CNN, Tokyo.